Hello viewers, welcome back to my channel. I am Neha Pariyani and in previous session we have started with the new topic, that is accounting for share capital, and I have explained you the concept of this in the previous topic in detail, okay, in the previous video. If you want to watch the previous video, then you can check the channel's playlists or you can get it at the end of this video. Okay, so in today's class we will be learning about journal entries for every process in this chapter, right? So first of all, let me explain you the concept in brief now, right? So first of all, assume that there is a company which requires certain capital, okay, certain additional capital. So company wants to issue share to the general public, right? So when general public, if the general public is interested, then they will be purchasing the shares of this particular company. Okay, assume A Company Limited, right? So now when the public will subscribe or purchase the shares of the company, so there is a process happening here. So for every process we need to record journal entries here. Okay, so let me explain you what are the process here. Okay, first of all, when company wants to issue the shares, company has to give an advertisement, okay, regarding or company has to give public notice regarding the plan for issue of shares. Okay, now suppose A Company Limited wants to issue 1000 shares, so company will give advertisement, then interested people can subscribe to their shares. Now while subscribing, assume this is general public, okay, so while subscribing, the general public will first pay the application money to the company, then it means that company is receiving application for shares. Okay, out of those, so basically first step here becomes application. Okay, application for purchasing or subscribing the shares of this company, correct? So then A Company Limited will receive applications, right? Then out of that, company will select how many applications should be selected and shares should be allotted, or whether to reject any applications. Okay, so after selectment, the company will allot the shares to the general public. Okay, so second process here is allotment of shares to the general public who has paid the application money, right? Then so when the allotment is done, then the general public becomes the shareholder of the company now. Okay, the public becomes shareholder. Now company after a certain time can do first call, okay, can do second call for asking the remaining amount of shares. So first call and second or final, or it could be also third call, fourth call, it depends upon company that how many calls the company is making. Okay, so the next process is calls process. So no matter how many calls are there, so they will be the next process. Okay, so this is the step. Now for you have to remember, for every step or every process we need to do two journal entries. Okay, so in today's session we are going to discuss what are the journal entries for each and every process. Okay, now so first let's discuss for the application process journal entries. Okay, remember, for every question you do in this chapter, journal entries will not change. Journal entries will be same for every process, but only the number of shares and the amount will change. Okay, so you have to be very careful with the number of shares and amount. We will learn everything in detail, but currently I am just discussing about the journal entries. Okay, for explaining this, I need to take an example. So assume that again same A Company Limited, okay, it's issuing 100 shares at the rate 10 each. So per share price is how much here? 10 rupees. Now company is asking general public to pay 4 rupees during application, 4 rupees on each share. Out of 10 rupees, company is asking to pay 4 rupees during application process, right? So application is the first process, we know that. Okay, now so what will happen, general public will first pay the application money to the bank account of the company. Okay, then company will select, as I told you, company will select the applications. right? So first process here is general public paying the money into the bank account of the company. So for application process, we need to do two journal entries. Okay, so what will be the journal entries now? Okay, first journal entries, as I told you, first of all, general public pays money into the bank account of the company. So bank account will be debited. See, bank is my asset. I mean, bank balance is my asset. So when people are paying the money through bank account, so my bank balance will increase, right? So when assets increases, we know the rule. When assets increases, we debit it. Okay, suppose for 100 shares, company is issuing 100 shares, right? 100 shares, company is asking 4 rupees during application. 4. So 400 rupees will be debited into company's bank account. Okay, so bank account is debited. Now two share application account, right? We are receiving amount, we are receiving this 400 rupees for the purpose of application. So two share application account will be credited. Clear? This is the first entry regarding the application process. Okay, you can write the narration B. Okay, let's write it. Being share application money, or you can write share application amount. Being share application money received for 100 shares at rupees 4. Clear? So this is how you can write the narration. So basically, first step is general public is paying the amount into company's bank account. Okay, now assume company wanted to issue 100 shares, but company received application for 1500 shares. Okay. No, sorry, 150 shares. Okay, so 50 shares are extra here, right? Now company has the choice. So whether the company wants to issue shares to everybody, all 150 members, okay, or it wants to issue shares to 100 members only. Okay, so after decision, right? So after decision, what will happen? Allotment will happen, but we are still in the application process now. So second entry in the application process is, see, we have received the amount into the bank account of the company. Okay, this will be transferred to the share capital account of the company. Right, this amount is still in the bank account of the company, but in the second journal entry in application process, we will transfer the share application money to share capital money, share capital account. Okay, now share capital, we know it's our liability, right? It's a liability for the firm. So when capital increases, now here capital is increasing, right? So when liability increases, we credit it. We know the rules. So share capital account is now credited. Okay, so we are transferring share application money to share capital money. So share application account is debited. Share application account debit to share capital account. To share capital account. Okay, here also 400 rupees will be credited. Now this 400 share application money is transferred to share capital account. Okay, so this is your second entry in the application process. Remember, for every question, these two entries will not change, this one and this one, but definitely here the number of shares and the amount will definitely change. So only that we need to take care of. Right, for narration here you can write being share application money, being share application money for 100 shares transferred to share capital account, transferred to share capital account. Okay, so these are the two entries here for application process. I hope it is clear. So when we'll do problems, then with practice we'll understand it better. Okay, so these two are the entries for the application process. Basically, what happened in this process? General public paid the application money, in the company's bank account and company transferred application money to the share capital account. Here, this is the first process. Now, second process, again, let's assume that same company. Okay, as I told you, if company is receiving, like company wanted to issue 100 shares, but it's receiving application for 150 shares. Now, company will choose whether to whether to allot shares to all or whether to reject the excess shares. Okay, all those things is called oversubscription. We'll learn it again. Okay, so basically in the second step, after receiving the application money from general public, now the company will allot the shares. Allot in the sense, company will distribute the shares to the general public on their name. Okay, suppose Mr. X has subscribed for 20 shares of A Limited. Now company will allot the shares to Mr. A. Okay, company will allot, suppose 20 shares to Mr. A by his name. Now Mr. A becomes the shareholder of the company. So second process here is allotment process. Now again in this step, we will be having two entries. For every process, we have two entries, right? So what will be the first entry now? Okay, now see here. So out of 10 rupees, if 10 rupees is the share value, okay, per share, in that 4 rupees we have already received during application process, right? Now, so out of 10 rupees, 4 rupees are received. Now, company is asking during allotment, you can pay us the 3 rupees. Out of 10, you have already paid us 4 rupees. So still 6 rupees are remaining. Out of that, 3 rupees you can pay during allotment. Company is asking to shareholders now. Okay, when company allots shares, the general public becomes shareholders. So company is asking allotment money. So allotment money is due, right? So first we need to do entry for asking the allotment amount. Then second entry we will do here, that is when general public pays the allotment money to the company. Clear? First company allots the shares and ask them to pay certain amount during allotment. And in the second journal entry, general public will pay that amount to the company. Okay. So for asking or for due entry now, the entry is share allotment account debit. Share allotment account debit. Okay. To share capital account. To share capital account. Okay. So for 100 shares, company asked to pay 3 rupees per share during allotment. So 300 rupees will be debited. Okay. Same will be credited. Okay. Company asked to pay the allotment money from general public. You can write the narration B, share allotment amount for 300 share, no, for 100 shares due. Still this amount is due, right? Company has asked, but still public has not paid it. Now in the second process or in the second entry during allotment process, assume public is paying the allotment money to the company. Okay, now again, public will pay money through bank account, right? So bank account now is credited because, no, debited because we are receiving certain amount into our bank account. Again, bank balance is my asset. So when bank balance increases, means asset is increasing. So I'll debit it. Clear? Bank account is debited to, now we have received it for the purpose of share allotment account is credited. Okay, same 300 rupees, or you can mention for 100 shares, public paid 3 rupees per share. So we received 300 rupees into our bank account. Okay, this is the second entry in the allotment process. Write narration B, share allotment money or amount for 100 shares at rupees 3 per share received. See, in the first entry, this amount was due, means company still did not receive the amount. But in the second entry, we are doing when company is receiving the allotment amount. So now it's received. Okay. Now, one thing you can remember here, that is in application process, first we have done the entry for receiving amount. Okay. In the allotment process, we are doing that entry second. In the second entry, we are receiving the amount. Okay. If you can see, just the both of the entries are opposite here. Opposite in case of application and allotment. Okay. See, first entry here was bank account debit to share application account during application process. Here, the second entry is bank account debit to share allotment account during allotment process. Clear? Then here in application process, the second entry was share application account debit because it's application process to share capital. Okay. Here the first entry is share allotment account because this is allotment process to share capital account. So basically both of them are opposite entry. The entry which is first in the application process is second in the allotment process. Okay, you can remember like that, or better to remember it by the process. Okay, first company allotted shares, it asked to pay the money, then after company asked, public is paying the money. Clear? Two entries in allotment process. Now third process, from third process it depends how many calls company is making. See, from 10 rupees company has received 4 rupees during application, 3 rupees during allotment. Okay, and still how much is remaining out of 10? Still 3 rupees are remaining. Okay, now it depends upon company. That company asked this full amount during first call itself, or company is asking again rupees, suppose like 1 rupees during first call, and after some time company might ask again 2 rupees during second call. It depends. Okay, assume that company is asking full 3 rupees during first call process itself. Now again in this process there will be two entries, right? So first entry is again same. So this is company, okay, and this is general public. Now company asks that you have already paid us in total 7 rupees, 4 during application, 3 during allotment. Now still 3 rupees is remaining with you, better to pay us that amount. We are in need of money. Company is again asking to pay the first call money to to shareholders. Okay. So again, asking entry will be share first call account debit. Share first call account debit to share capital account. Okay, to share capital account. For 100 shares, company is asking 3 rupees to pay during first call. So 300 rupees is debited, same will be credited. Okay, write the narration being share first call amount on 100 shares at rupees 3 per share due. Okay, it's still due, right? Company is still asking to pay the amount. We have recorded the entry for asking. Now after company asks, assume that general public is paying that amount. So now not general public, actually shareholders are paying the amount to company. So again, my bank account will be debited. I'm receiving certain amount in my bank account. So my asset is increasing, bank account is debited. Now it will be to share first call account. To share first call account. Okay. So we have received it for the purpose of share first call. Now write the narration. Same 300 rupees on debit and credit. Company asked to pay 300 rupees during first call, and general public paid rupees 300 during first call. You can write the narration being share first call amount received. Okay, you can mention the number of shares and first call money per share. You can mention all this in narration. Okay, Now this is your entry for second call process. Now if you see almost allotment process entries and first call process entries are totally same. So just instead of mentioning allotment everywhere, I have mentioned the word called share first call. Okay, you have to be just very clear with the process. Okay, if you are clear with the process, then it's very easy to do the journal entries. Now if assume company was making second call also, like suppose during first call company asked only 1 rupees. Now after some time again company is doing second call. So now what will be the entries? During second call, assume company is asking to pay remaining 2 rupees out of 10. Right? Now what will be the entry? So entry will be share second call account debit to share capital account. Okay. Asking entry is same for every process. Just the process name will change. So share second call account debit to share capital account. For 100 shares, company is asking 2 rupees. So 200 rupees will be debited and 200 will be credited. Okay. After asking, assume general public or shareholders are paying this amount to the company. Now, again, my bank balance will increase. So bank account debit rupees 200. Okay, 200 to share second call account. Will be credited with rupees 200. Okay, if this is the last call which is to be done by the company, if all 10 rupees have been received, then this will be second and final call. Okay, you should mention it as second and final call. If all 3 rupees, all 3 remaining rupees were received during first call process itself, then this will be called as first and final call. Here, then you have to mention it as share first and final call account debit. Okay. Assume company is asking only 1 rupees during second call. After some time, again company will make third call. So then this will not be the final call. Then third will be the third and final call account debit. Entry will again be same. Share third and final call account debit to share capital for asking or due entry. And while payment, okay, so when public will pay the money to the company, again bank account debit to share third and final call account. Okay, I told you the entries will always be same for all the problems. You just have to be very careful with these amount. Clear? So for better understanding, let us try to do a small problem here. Okay, so Karnataka Limited issued 1000 equity shares. Okay, of rupees 10 each. At the amount payable was as follows. Right, so rupees 1 on application. First of all, company is issuing 1000 shares of rupees 10 each. Okay, so out of this 10 rupees. Rupees 1 will be received during application. Okay, rupees 4 will be received during allotment and rupees 5 will be received during first and final call. Okay, so this is how company is going to receive this 10 rupees. Right, then all the shares will subscribe by the public and allotment money was duly collected. Pass necessary journal entries. So for this process, for whole of this process, we need to do the journal entries. So we know first is application process, and in every process we have 2 entries. So I have explained you the process, right? So company is issuing the, you can say company is giving public notice or giving advertisement regarding its issue. Now public is paying the application money first. Okay, public will pay the application money first, then the company will consider those applications. Without payment of application money, company will not consider them as applications. So only in application process, first we will receive the money. In later all processes, first company will ask, then we will receive the amount. So here we know the entry. First entry is bank account debit. So people paid application money into my bank account to share application account. to share application account. For 1,000 shares, public has paid me 1 rupees during application, right? 1 rupees on application. So I received 1,000 rupees during application. Clear? Write the narration being share application amount, or you can also write being share application money. For 1,000 shares at the rate rupees 1 per share received. First, company is receiving the application money. Clear? Then what will be the second entry in the application process? So the entry here is company is transferring this application money to share capital account. Okay, company is transferring share application amount from share application account to share capital account. So the entry now will be share application account debit. Share application account debit to share capital account. To share capital account. Okay, so same 1,000 rupees. Full application money is transferred to share capital account. You can write the narration being share application money or share application amount transferred to share capital account. You can again mention the number of shares and application money per share in the narration, right? So two entries for application process are done here. So what will be the second process or second step? Now after receiving application, company will allot the share or company will distribute the share to its shareholders here by their name. So second is allotment process. While allotting the shares, company is asking to pay 4 rupees during allotment. Out of 10, 1 rupee is already paid during application. Now during allotment, company is telling to pay or company is asking to pay 4 rupees from general public. So first we have to do the entry for asking, or you can say due entry. Okay, so what is the due entry now? Third journal entry. So in our allotment process, again we know we have two journal entries. First one is, so share allotment account debit. Okay, company is asking for 1,000 shares to pay 4 rupees per share. Okay, to share capital account. To share capital account. So company asked to pay 4,000 rupees in total for 1,000 shares during allotment. You can write the narration being share allotment money or share allotment amount for 1,000 shares at the rate rupees 4 per share due. Okay, due. Still company has asked, public has not yet paid during this entry. Okay, now the second entry during allotment process will be, now the general public or the shareholders are actually paying the allotment amount. After company asks, public is paying the amount now. So my bank account is debited now. Okay, I am receiving allotment money into my bank account. So bank account debit to share allotment account. We received it for the purpose of share allotment. Okay, so for 1,000 shares, again 4 rupees. Same, we received 4,000 rupees. Company asked to pay 4,000 rupees and public paid 4,000 rupees. Write narration being, so being share allotment money or allotment amount received. Clear? Then, so next what we have, second step is also then second process. Okay, company asked for allotment money and general public paid the allotment money. Then again after some time, company is making first and final call. It means out of 10 rupees, after some time, assume after 2 to 3 months, company is in need of money. So company is doing first and final call. Final call in the sense, all the balance, all the remaining amount from per share is being received in this process itself. So again, we need to do 2 journal entries for the first call process. Okay, first and final call process. So entry will be same. First, company will ask to pay the final call amount. Then in the second entry, public will pay the second final call amount. Okay, so first due entry, or you can say asking entry, share, first and final call account debit for 1000 shares, company is asking to pay 5 rupees to share capital account. To share capital account. In total, company is asking remaining 5000 rupees to pay, okay, from its shareholders, being share first and final call account, final call amount due on 1000 shares at the rate rupees 5 each or 5 per share. It's still due. Company asked to pay the amount. Now in the second entry, assume all the general public, no, all the shareholders are paying the amount to the company. So my bank account or company's bank account will now be debited. Bank account debit to share first call, first and final call account. Okay, for full 5000 rupees. Assume all the shareholders paid the first call amount. So 5000 rupees we received. Write the narration being share first and final call amount received. Clear? Now see here, in question they have told company issued 1000 shares at rupees 10 each. So in total, company should be receiving 10,000 rupees from the general public if the company is issuing shares. Okay, in that, out of 10,000, company has received 1,000 during application. Okay, then company has received 4,000 into bank account during allotment, and company has received 5,000 rupees during first call in the bank account. So in total, in our bank account, we received 1,000 plus 4,000 plus 5,000. In total, 10,000 rupees. Right? So this is how company has made the distribution. If company wanted, company can also do the second call. Like during first call, company can ask only 3 rupees, and remaining 2 rupees could have been asked during second call. But all that depends upon the company. Okay. And another one hint I would like to give you here, that is, you can see all the process journal entries. Right here we have share application account in the credit side. If you cancel this share application account, if you cancel this, what is remaining? Bank account debit to share capital account. Okay, so what is remaining? Bank to share capital. Now let's go to allotment process and see here. We have allotment account here in the first entry on the debit side. Cancel it. In the second entry, we have it on the credit side. Cancel it. So again, what is remaining now? Bank account debit to share capital account. Okay, then again, come back to third entry or third process. Share first and final call account debit is on the debit side now. And in the first entry, so cancel it. And in the second entry, it's on the credit side. Okay, so cancel it. Again, what is remaining? Bank account debit to share capital account. This is what is remaining, right? Bank debit to share capital account. Ultimately, we will receive amount into our bank account for the share capital, right? But these will be the temporary accounts. This share capital account, no, share application account, share allotment account, share first call account. If we do second call entry, then share second call account. these all will be temporary accounts, which will be created when company is asking to pay the money. Ultimately, we will receive money in our bank account and we will then transfer it to share capital account itself. We are receiving the money for share capital itself, but we have just divided into processes. But you all have to show the all the entries in detail. Okay, all the process should have two entries. Entries will not change, amounts will definitely change from question to question. I hope you have understood this question. Again, there are many more concepts in this chapter. So all those we will be learning in my upcoming sessions. And yes, so there is a chronological order of videos regarding this chapter. Okay, if you skip any part or if you skip any video, suppose you have watched the first video, then you're directly coming to third one, you will not understand. I am trying to record all the videos in a process, and I'll also put the link of playlist in the description box below as well as at the end of this video. So first come from order wise, or else it's impossible to understand this particular chapter. Okay, so we will be covering upcoming topics in my next videos. So if you liked this particular video, then please hit the like button. Also subscribe to the channel, share the video with your friends. You can ask me any doubts in the comment section below. I hope to see you all in my upcoming videos. Till that, happy learning.